touch typing is all about discipline and practice. It's easy to remember where all of the keys are on the keyboard, but practicing in a way that improves your speed and accuracy is challenging. By focusing specifically on each finger in each keystroke, you can quicken the way in which you learn to type fast and accurate. Hi everyone, I'm Anson Alexander, and welcome to Touch Typing Middle Finger Mastery. If you've been following along in my other touch typing tutorials, you should now be comfortable typing all of the keys in the home row, all of the primary keys typed by your index fingers, and you should be comfortable using your pinky fingers to type shift. In this lesson, we're going to look specifically at the keys typed by the middle fingers, we're going to clear up any concerns there may be about the spacebar, and then we're going to put everything together and type some real words and full sentences. Remember, the typing chart that I show throughout these videos is available for print or download along with other typing instruction at AnsonAlex.com. The link is in the description. Now, let's take a look at mastering touch typing with the middle fingers. In addition to the home row key of D, the middle finger is also responsible for the keys 3, E, and C. Remember to always return to the home row in between keystrokes, as this will help you create muscle memory more quickly. The right middle finger is responsible for the home row key of K, as well as the keys 8, I, and comma. When typing the numbers 3 and 8, you may notice that it's difficult to do without your other fingers moving off of the home row. This is normal and will improve with practice. Do your best to keep those fingers as close to their home row positions as possible, but obviously to make those long-range keystrokes, they may have to move off their home row position a little bit. What's even more important is getting them back to the home row without having to look. In almost any typing instruction, the fundamental rule is that your fingers return to the home row after every single keystroke. There are many reasons for this, but the main one is to create muscle memory, which means that you can type letters without consciously having to think about them. You'll just type them automatically. Now, if you understand this concept, you'll understand that the best way to do this is to have your fingers leaving the home row, typing a letter, and then returning to the home row over and over and over again. If you just leave your finger up by the letter you're going to type, you're not creating that muscle memory. So although it may seem boring, this actually creates a long-term benefit for you. So typing letters over and over repetitively actually has a real science-backed reason, and again, that's muscle memory. Of course, you can always cheat and keep your fingers kind of near the center of the keyboard, halfway look whenever you're typing, and you can probably type pretty fast. But if you do that in 6 months, a year, 2 years from now, you'll probably be typing at that exact same speed. While those who've been disciplined and didn't look at the keyboard, built up that muscle memory, will be typing a lot faster. So the choice is yours. Now, we've learned which keys the middle fingers are responsible for. We've retouched upon the importance of muscle memory. So let's start practicing these new keystrokes, and then we can combine them with the keystrokes that we've already learned to start creating some muscle memory of our own. The first step is to do what we've done for our other fingers in previous lessons. Open up a blank document and start to type the new letters without looking. So we can go 3, E, D, C, 8, I, K, comma. Then we can start adding some spaces, 3, space E, space D, space C, space 8, space I, space K, space comma. And you might notice me cheating a little bit, but definitely return to the home row because you're going to build that muscle memory. I already have that muscle memory, right? So it's not quite as important. I can cheat now because I've already created that muscle memory, and you'll get there too. We could also start adding some capitals. So I could go the capital 8, capital I, capital K, capital comma, which is the less than symbol. And then of course we could hit space and do it for the other side, capital 3, capital E, capital D, capital C. Now you want to keep doing this for quite a while with just these new letters that we're just learning, and especially if you find one that is a little bit more difficult than others, you can start to practice that one. You can even just, you know, do it repetitively, 8, 8, and try and keep those fingers close to the home row. Your fingers might start to hurt, but that's how you build that muscle memory and you make your fingers more nimble. Go ahead and practice typing these letters over and over again with your middle fingers until you feel more comfortable. Also, remember to practice using the spacebar as well. Obviously, either thumb can be used to make that keystroke. Oftentimes, people use their dominant hand. You should be able to do that without it sacrificing speed. Your dominant hand should be able to keep up with all of its other keystrokes as well. So it's really a personal preference. I happen to be a right-handed spacebar kind of guy. So it's up to you. As you practice, remember to always return to the home row in between keystrokes and to use the finger chart if you can't find the right key instead of looking at the keyboard. Now let's start practicing some full sentences by using the keys in the home row, the keys typed by our index fingers, and the keys typed by our middle fingers. You can follow along in the video, but I'm also going to post a longer document with more of these sentences in it on antsandalex.com, so you can open that up and you can start trying to type those sentences as well. The link, again, is in the description. Okay, so the first sentence is, as an avid science fan, I read many time travel pieces. So let's go for it. As an avid science fan, I read many time travel pieces. There we go. Second one is, Sadie likes dancing. She has much skill. Sadie likes dancing, semicolon, she has much. Oh, I had an autocorrect in there for me. Okay, well, that helps. Third one is, Jeff's dream car is a red Ferrari. He's been saving years. Jeff's dream car is a red Ferrari. He's been saving years. And these sentences may seem a little weird, but that's because we can't use certain letters like the important O letter, which we'll learn in the next lesson. The fourth sentence is, the cat is chasing after the rat, but it is very fast. The cat is chasing, typo. See, we all have typos. After the rat, but it is very fast. You can see that I've got that delete pretty quick as well. You'll get there with that pinky. We're gonna talk about that in the next lesson. The last sentence is, the navy blue shirt had a small tear at the hem. The navy blue shirt had a small tear at the hem. Okay, so we've typed these five sentences. Again, there's a longer list on antsandalex.com, so if you're looking for more varied practice, go ahead and open that up or download it. If you find that your main struggle is remembering where the keys are, it may be best to go back to practicing individual keystrokes and fingers so that you can build up that muscle memory. For example, if you're struggling with the C key, open up a blank document and start typing it over and over again, always returning to the home row in between. Throw in some other letters for variation, but make sure that you're spending a lot of time practicing those troublesome keystrokes to build up more muscle memory. When it comes to practicing and improving, this is something that should be done over weeks and months. It may be best to devote specific time to practicing touch typing and maybe devote a particular week to a particular finger. By doing that, you can do those repetitive keystrokes to build that muscle memory over time. If you're looking for more detailed typing instruction, don't forget to check out my full touch typing course available on LinkedIn Learning. The link is also in the description. If you found this video helpful, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. Once you're ready, go ahead and move on over to the next lesson where we cover both the ring and the pinky fingers. Thanks for watching. That's all I have for you for today. This is Anson from AntsandAlex.com.